And welcome to our YouTube channel No Homeopathy, and here Samriddhi Sharma is here to guide you. In today's video, I am going to review a book that is Basics of Materia Medica, Must Read for Homeopaths. That is authored by Dr. Yogeshwari Gupta, Dr. Suchita Chhatri and Dr. Varsha Sharma. So what are the important points or what is the essentiality of this book? This is I am going to provide you in this video. And what are the years of the BHMS for which the book is recommended by the authors, I am going to provide a view of that. Okay, so without wasting your time, let's start this video. So first of all, if you see on the title, that is the Basics of Materia Medica. So as the title suggests, the book contains the basic information of the Materia Medica, and author also states in the preface that this book does not contain the medicine's information. Okay, this book contains the basic information which you must know before reading the medicines. It contains the essential information which a student must know before reading the medicines. Okay. And it is also written in the title, a must read for homeopaths. So why it is written a must read for homeopaths? Because if any of the homeopath is going to read any of the medicine, okay, for which he or she must have the basic knowledge. What are the temperaments? What are the diathesis? Because in each and every medicine, it is written the constitution, temperament, diathesis, or aggravations, or any of the terms that are commonly in each and every medicine. So before going to read out the medicine's information, you must know what are the terms that are used in different portions. You must know what are the terminologies, what are the meaning of that. Okay, next important part is that authors recommend this book both for the PG as well as UG curriculum. Okay, why it is recommended? Because if you see the question paper of the BHMS first to final year, or if you see the PG question paper, these questions are commonly asked in the question. What I found interesting in this book contains from the beginning information that what is the definition of the Materia Medica, what is the history of the Materia Medica, different systems Materia Medica are also explained, that is the ancient Egypt system of medicine, Roman system, Greek system, Chinese system, Yunani system. So all the Materia Medica in various systems are also explained. Next is the most important question, the nature of our homeopathic Materia Medica. This is also covered in this book. And most important question that is frequently asked by the students of the UG as well as the PG ones, that is the sources of the homeopathic Materia Medica. It is covered, and the source book of the homeopathic Materia Medica, this is also covered. And this is a very important chapter which I found in this book, that is source book of homeopathic Materia Medica. And if you see the chapter, it is very well written, and this I must say that this is the student friendly book. Why I'm saying this? Because the students needs a concise information of the subject before going to the examination. So if you are also going to give the exam, you must read out this book. So when you see out this chapter, that is the source book of homeopathic Materia Medica, it is beautifully written, and it contains all the essential information the UG as well as the PG students need to know of the Materia Medica. So this is a very important question of the question paper which is asked in your 5 as well as 10 marks. So please refer this chapter when you are going to give the examination. So it also contains clear pictures of the Materia Medicas, that is if the author discussed about the fragmenta, so fragmenta image is given. If the author is discussing about the Materia Medica Pura, so Materia Medica Pura image is given. So bahut sare students aise hote hain jo kya karte hain, unko रीड आउट कर लेते हैं कि ऐसा है, बट कभी उन्होंने मटेरिया मेडिका को देखा नहीं होता कि मटेरिया मेडिका क्रॉनिक डिजीजेस कैसी दिखती है, तो ऑथर ने उसकी फोटोग्राफ्स जो हैं वो भी दे रखी हैं ताकि आप लोगों को समझ में आ जाए कि ये जो बुक है वो इस तरीके से दिखाई देती है. ओके, टाइप्स ऑफ होम्योपैथिक मटीरिया मेडिका. सो दिस इज़ ऑल्सो अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर विच इज़ ऑल्सो आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर एंड इट इज़ ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी वेल रिटन व्हेन यू रेफर आउट दिस चैप्टर. ओके, नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस बुक इज़ मैथड्स टू स्टडी द मटीरिया मेडिका. वॉट आर द डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मैथड्स टू स्टडी द मटीरिया मेडिका. दिस इज़ ऑल्सो एलैबोरेटेड इन दिस बुक एंड यू कैन रेफर आउट दिस चैप्टर. एंड व्हेन आई वाज सीइंग द चैप्टर्स ऑफ दिस बुक आई फाउंड आउट दैट कि जिस तरीके से स्टूडेंट चाहता है कि हमारे लिए इस तरीके से बुक लिखी जाए. बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं जो ऐसे कहते हैं कि ऑथर इस तरीके से नहीं लिख सकता था क्या. तो जिस तरीके से स्टूडेंट चाहता है कि एकदम से कहीं हमें इधर उधर भागना नहीं पड़े और अच्छे से हमें एक कंसाइज इन्फॉर्मेशन जो है उस टॉपिक की मिल जाए. तो दिस इज़ व्हाट आई फाउंड इन दिस बुक. दिस इज़ स्टूडेंट्स फ्रेंडली बुक. मैनी ऑथर्स हैव रिटन द बुक इन द वे कि जो स्टूडेंट है उसको मैटर छाटना पड़ता है उस बुक में से भी. सो यहाँ पर ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. यहाँ पे आपको जो कंटेंट है वो इस तरीके से ही लिखा हुआ है कि आपको इधर उधर इसमें से छाटने की ज़रूरत नहीं है कि बहुत लेंदी कर रखा हो. नथिंग इज़ लेंदी. इट इज़ रिटन इन द वेरी वेरी सिंपल लैंग्वेज ऑल्सो. ओके, नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज स्कोप ऑफ होम्योपैथिक मटीरिया मेडिका एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ होम्योपैथिक मटीरिया मेडिका. दिस इज़ ऑल्सो clearly stated in the book and this is also asked in the 5 or 10 marks of your question paper. Okay, next is biochemic system of medicine. What is the history of the biochemic and what are the principles on which the biochemic system of medicine works? It's clearly elaborated. And what are the basics of nosodes and sarcodes are given. The books on the nosodes of the materia medica, you can refer this one. And what are the basics of the sarcodes, similar headings are given as of the nosodes, that is preparation of the sarcodes, indications of the sarcodes, contraindications, and what are the materia medica books on the sarcodes. Next, okay. There is a chapter on the drug relationship and it contains information about the complementary, what are the complementary medicines, what are the compatible medicines, what are incompatible, antidote meaning, concordance meaning. So these are covered in this chapter. What are the cognate and what is the meaning of the cognate. These are the topics of the drug relationship which are covered in this chapter of the book. And I would say that this is something, a very important chapter for both PG and as well as UG student, because this is asked in the question paper. And when you are going to give the medicine in your clinical practice also, you must know that which remedy is inimical to which one and what is the meaning of the inimical. Actually, what is the meaning of the inimical? What is the meaning of the complementary? What is the meaning of the cognate? So you must know when you are giving out the medicine. And in your clinical practice also, you must know these terms for the UG or as well as a PG student. This chapter is important. And the last chapter that deals with the commonly used terms in the materia medica, that is what is a miasm, what is a temperament, what is a diathesis, constitution, and thermals, modalities. So this chapter deals with these terms and it also contains information of the doctrine of signature. So this is a interesting chapter which I found, that doctrine of signature with a photograph, it is given in this book. Okay, so I would recommend this book for the academics as well as for the clinical ones. And for the academic student from the first to final year, I will recommend this book. And for the PG students, I will recommend this book. And also for the clinicians, for the practitioners who are giving out the medicines and who want to gain the basic knowledge about what the terminology is meaning. So author also clearly stated that this book doesn't contain any of the medicinal information, but it contains a basic information before you are going to read out the medicine. So this is the book which I highly recommend to all the clinicians as well as the academicians. So just go and refer this book of the Materia Medica if you want to gain the information of the basics ones. Okay, so that's all for today's video. I hope this video is going to be useful and helpful to you. If you find out this video useful and helpful, try to share out with the friends and colleagues who are also searching to get a book which will help them in the future of the examinations as well as in the future of the clinical practice. So that's all. Thanks for watching. No homeopathy.